وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ and compete with each other, vie with each other to get the forgiveness from your Lord وَجَنَّةٍ and to get and reach the paradise أَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ whose breadth is just like the breadth of the heavens and the earth أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ and that has been prepared for those having taqwa الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ who are those who have taqwa الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ who keep on expending and spending their money for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prosperity as well as adversity وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ who can restrain their anger وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ who forgive who are forgiving for humanity towards people وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ and Allah loves such good doers وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً and those who when they commit something which is indecent by mistake, by error something is committed by them which is indecent أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ or they do wrong to themselves in any other way ذَكَرُوا اللَّهِ instantly, immediately they remember Allah Allah comes to their mind فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ then they repent what we have done and they ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their sins وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ and who can forgive the sins except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself وَلَمْ يُسِرُّوا عَلَىٰ مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ and then they don't insist and persist in the sin mistake is committed The Prophet has been reported to have said in one hadith, كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَّعُونَ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّعِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ All mankind are those who commit errors. خَطَّعُونَ They go on committing errors. But among these خَطَّعُونَ those who commit errors, among them the best are those who repent, who revert to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who repent on what they have done. And they again make a firm resolve that they will not again commit this act and this sin. فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَغْفِرُوا ذُنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَمْ يُسِرُّوا عَلَىٰ مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ Knowingly, they do not insist and persist in that sin. أُولَٰئِكَ جَزَاؤُهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَجَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ They are the people for whom is the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their Lord. From their Lord was Jannatun, and for them are the gardens, tajri min tahtiha al-anhar, beneath which the rivers are flowing. Khalidina fiha, they will dwell in them forever. Wa ni'ma ajrul amilin, and how good is the reward, how excellent is the reward for those people who do good works. Qad khalat min qablikum sunanun fasiru fil ard. So many examples, similar examples have passed before you. قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ سُنُنُ You are not the first nation and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the first messenger. So many messengers were sent before, so many nations. You know what happened to the people of Hud and people of Saleh? They were in this very Arabian peninsula, these both nations. So قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ سُنُنُ فَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ You should travel in the land. فَانْظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الْمُكَذِّبِينَ And see for yourself what was the end of the believers, the liars of the truth, who didn't accept Iman at the hands of their messengers. What happened to them? They were just, you know, finished. هَذَا بَيَانٌ لِلنَّاسِ وَهُدًى وَمَوْعِدَةٌ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ This Quran is a manifesto for mankind. And this is the guidance. And this is the exhortation and admonition for the God-fearing. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ Because there was, you know, a temporary defeat. Although finally Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again gave the Muslims the victory. The army had to retire, had to go back. The army of the Quraysh, Abu Sufyan had to take the back to his army. But you know, temporarily there was defeat. And there were wounds inflicted. So many were injured. So actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning Because due to that, there was the morale had gone down. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا Don't be disheartened. Don't get disheartened. And don't be grieved. We make a solemn promise with you. You will be the supreme on earth. You will be above others. You will be supreme. In kuntum mu'mineen, only if you remain mu'min, if you have real faith, if you have the real conviction, not the verbal attestation only. The verbal attestation we have, and we are more than a billion. We have no say in the international affairs, in the world, affairs of the world, nothing. We carry no weight, more than a billion, and meaning nothing. Because we have only verbal attestation. We say that we believe in Allah. We say with our tongue, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Where is the conviction? Look to our character, our attitudes, our pursuits, our values. After what we are running, that will tell us what is the real faith, what is the real belief, what are our real goals in life, what is our value structure. So voila, this ayah is very important, because this proves for sure that majority of the Muslims of this time are not Mu'mins. Had they been Mu'min, they would have been, they should have been supreme on earth. وَلَا تَهِنُوا. Either you have to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told a lie, ma'az Allah. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا أَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. You will be supreme, you will be above all if you are mu'min. And we are not, so we are not mu'min. إِن يَمْسَتْكُمْ قَرْهٌ فَقَدْ مَسَّ الْقَوْمَ قَرْهٌ مِسْلُهُ. If a wound has been inflicted upon you, O Muslims, 70 of you have been martyred to the whole community, as if just as a wound to an individual, this was a big wound to the community, to the Ummah, 70. And one of them was Hazrat Hamza radiallahu ta'ala. The other one was Hazrat Musa bin Umair radiallahu ta'ala, who was the emissary of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was sent from Makkah to teach the people of Medina Quran. And he was also martyred. If you have been inflicted with a wound, your enemies, the other people, they had also got the infliction of a wound. And these days, we keep on rotating them between the people, ups and downs, downs and ups. Not no nation can have the same condition throughout. Ups and downs come and go in the history, in the life of a nation and a community. تِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَابِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ وَلَيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sees who is real mu'min. If there is no adversity, if there are no testing, if there are no tribulations, how will it be proved who is the real Muslim? In conditions of ease and comfort, everybody can claim. Everybody can have tall claims of Iman and Islam. It is actually on some testing, on some trial, that it can be proved who is the real mu'min. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to make it manifest. Who is the real mu'min? وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَاءَ. And He wanted to get from you some witnesses, some martyrs, so that they become the witnesses. وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الظَّالِمِينَ. It is not that Allah loves these zalimeen, these kuffar. Allah doesn't like these non-believers. But actually, if He allowed this infliction of this wound to you as an ummah, this has also some wisdom behind it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could compensate for the mistake which was committed by 35. He could condone the mistake. And this, you know, infliction, this wound would not have come to you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed it. Why? So that, number one, He wanted to see that it should become manifest. Who is the real mu'min? Who are those who are steadfast, who are perseverant, who can show perseverance? And number two, He wanted to have some witnesses from amongst you. Allah doesn't like these kuffar, these mushrikeen. وَلَيُمَحْرِصَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَبْحَقَ الْكَافِرِينَ. And that Allah may purge those who shall enter the garden. You should purge those who believe, and may blot out the disbelievers, who wanted to liquidate the disbelievers.